Good afternoon, everybody. This is Ablas, Assistant Professor in Civil Engineering Department from the Chaplin Engineering College. This is the subject hydraulics and hydraulic machines. Now I will going to explain the topic 7. Topic name is most economical circular section and based on the concept, I will explain also the problems also. Now going to the derivation, most economical circular section. For a most economical circular section, the discharge for the discharge and area of the slope of the bed is resistant coefficient is maximum. For the maximum resistant discharge, we are maintain the area of the cross-section, area of the economical section, slope of the bed, and the resistant coefficient is maximum. We are maintain the in this point. What they said, area of the cross-section of the circular channel and the slope of the bed of the channel and the resistant coefficient, we are keep it in maximum condition. For getting the maximum discharge, we are keep the area, slope of the bed and resistant coefficient is keep it in maximum condition. But in the case of the economical sections, we are keep the area, slope and bed resistant coefficient are putting in maximum. But circular channels, in the case of circular channels, the area of flow cannot be maintained constant. With the change of depth of flow in a circular channel of any radius, the wetted area and the wetted perimeter changes. Thus, in case of circular channels, for most economical section, two separate conditions are obtained. What there is said in this para, for the general most economical sections, for getting the maximum discharge, we are kept the cross-section area, slope of the bed and resistance coefficients are put in maximum, maintaining maximum. By the maintaining these terms in maximum, we are acquiring the maximum discharge in normal economical sections. But in the case of the circular channels, the area due to the circular conditions, the depth of the flow in the circular channel of any radius, the flow cannot be constant in circular channel because of depth of the flow circular channel at any radius. The radius will be changed at the depth of the channel, the wetted area and wetted perimeter changes due to the radius changing of the radius, the radius is variable, not constant, the radius is changed at point to point, the radius is changed in the circular channel due to that condition, the depth of the flow also is changed with depth, changed with radius. The depth also we changed with radius. Due to this condition, the area and perimeter also be changes. The area and perimeter are not constant in the flow channels, in the circular channels. So in this case, the circular channels of the most economical sections, we are dividing into the two conditions. Condition for maximum velocity, condition for maximum discharge. We are separately divided and separately find out and derive the conditions for maximum velocity in the maximum velocity of the water flow and derive the conditions for maximum discharge of the water flow. We are derived and fixed some conditions. By the following conditions, based on that conditions, we are constructed the circular channel. We are getting maximum velocity and we are getting a monsoon discharge. For maximum velocity, what are the conditions we are going to maintain and that derivation is going to first derivation condition of maximum velocity. By which conditions we are getting maximum discharge for deriving that conditions. That condition is in the second condition for maximum discharge. So by these two deriving two conditions, we are considered the most economical circular channel. So first condition is, for going to the first condition, the condition is condition for maximum velocity per circular section. So this is the circular channel. So this is the circular channel. Here small d is the depth of the water flow, is the center of the channel O, is the radius of the channel is theta, is the angle made by the channel. So here small d is depth of the water. Here two theta both sides take as 2 theta, angle subtended at the center of by the water surface, angle subtended at the center of the center by the water surface, by the water surface at the center of the channel. Both sides two angles are generated. The two angles are taken as 2 theta. Here small r equal to radius of channel. Small r equal to radius of channel. I is the slope of the bed. So here first condition we find out the velocity. Condition for maximum velocity. So the velocity of the flow according to this formula. Velocity of the flow according to this formula. V equal to C root MI. So here M equal to formula here A by P, wetted area by wetted perimeter. So the value C equal to root of A by P, C equal to root of A by P into Y. The velocity of flow through circular channel will be maximum, and the hydraulic mean depth MR A by P is maximum for a given value of C and I. Case of circular pipe, the variable is theta only, hence the maximum value A by P is conditioned. Here, for the most economical circular channel, we are getting the maximum value of hydraulic mean depth. M is getting maximum value, hydraulic mean depth is maximum, and C and maximum for given value of C and I. For the given value of series constant and I slope value for the most economical circular channel, the hydraulic mean depth will be going to the maximum. We are maintaining the hydraulic mean depth in the maximum at the given C and V values. For the circular pipe, theta is variable. C and I value will be constant. Constant values, hydraulic mean depth will be maximum, but theta value is variable. Theta value is changed, is not constant. Hence, maximum value of A by P, you have the condition for getting, for here in this point we discussed, we are maintaining the hydraulic mean depth will be maximum. For getting of that hydraulic maximum value, we are differentiating the hydraulic mean depth A by P. D into A by P by D theta equal to 0. Here, this is equation 1. A and P both are functions of theta. Here, A and P are both are functions of theta. The value of wetted area. Now, the find out the value of wetted area from the equation. A equal to R square into theta minus sine 2 theta by 2. A equal to R square into theta minus sine 2 theta by 2. This is equation 2. The value of wetted perimeter P is given by equation from 16.60. P equal to 2 R theta. These values are getting from the most economical flow through circular channels. So differentiate equation 1 with respect to theta. Differentiate equation with respect to theta. P into dA by d theta minus A into dP by d theta by P. p into da by d theta minus a into dp by d theta minus p square equal to 0. Here p square and p are cancelled, so in remaining value is d. 1 p is p square and p are cancelled, 1 p is there, so remaining value is p into da by d theta minus a into dp by d theta equal to 0. This is getting both equation first. From the equation 2, dA by dt equal to dA by dt equal to equation 2 r square into 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2 into 2. Just rewrite this like this. Sin theta minus sin 2 theta by 2 is writing like this. Here theta is common, 1 minus sin. You're getting 1 minus cos theta by 2 into 2. So here 2 are cancelled, you are getting r square into 1 minus cos 2 theta. From the equation 3, p equal to r 2r theta is the equation 3. We differentiate the weighted perimeter 2 with respect to theta, dp by theta equal to 2 theta. Here theta is differentiation of theta with respect to theta is getting the value 1. So dp by theta equal to 2r. Substitute the values a and p into p da by d theta and dp by d theta in the equation 4. So p value is getting is 2r theta minus da by dt value is getting is r square 1 minus cos 2 theta minus a value is here getting r square theta minus sin 2 theta by 2. Sin 2 theta by 2 into 2r equal to 0. Here dp by data is dp by data value is equal to 2r. So here 2r cube multiply the equation from the outside value, 2r cube theta into 1 minus cos 2 theta minus 2 into 2r into r square equal to 2r cube into theta minus 2r into r square equal to this 2r, multiply with respect to this 2r cube into theta minus sine 2 theta by 2 equal to 0. Cancelling 2r cube on both sides, minus 2r cube and plus 2r cube are both are cancelling the values, cancel remaining values, theta minus 1 minus theta minus 1 minus cos 2 theta minus sin 2 theta by 2 equal to 0. Next one, theta minus cos 2 theta minus minus of plus minus into minus plus theta plus sin 2 theta by 2. So cos theta, here theta cos 2 theta equal to sin 2 theta by 2. You are getting theta minus theta is getting cos 2 theta equal to theta into cos 2 theta equal to sin 2 theta. Here denominator 2 and denominator 2 are cancelled. We are getting 2 theta equal to, we need the value of theta. So 2 theta equal to sin 2 theta by cos 2 theta. Sin 2 theta by cos 2 theta equal to tan 2 theta equal to 2 theta. The solution of equation is by hit and trial gives. By the trial and errors measure, the 2 theta value is getting as 257 degrees 30 minutes approximately. The getting value is from that theta equal to half 257 degrees 30 minutes by 2, 128 degrees 45. The depth of the flow for maximum velocity, and find out the small depth of the flow for maximum velocity in the OD minus OC. Here OD minus is getting the value. For that, you take the OD minus into OD minus into OC. OD minus into OC. OD equal to here OD equal to R. OD equal to R. Kepler. OC equal to R. R sin R cos theta. OD equal to OD minus OC. OD equal to R. OC equal to R cos theta value. So for that R value, R into common, we getting here, okay, taking the common of R value, R into 1 minus cos theta, R into 1 minus theta value is here 138 degrees 45 minutes, R equal to 1 minus cos into 180 minus 128 degrees 45 minutes equal to 51 degrees 15 minutes. 51 degrees 15 minutes. So we're getting the value 1 R into 1 minus cos 51 degrees 15 minutes. We're getting the 1 plus cos 51 degrees 15 minutes. So R into 1 plus the value of 1 plus the value of cos 51 degrees 15 minutes is equal to 0.62. 1 plus 0.62 equal to 1.62. Into R, 1.62 into R, 1.62 into R equal to D by 2, R equal to D by 2, R is the value is equal to half of the D by 2, so 1.62 by 2 equal to value 0.81D, 1.62 by 2 is 0.81D value. This is the condition for, this is the one of the condition for maximum elastic. Small d equal to you are maintained. We are in the construction of the time, we are maintained that small d equal to 0.81d. This is equation 16.18. Diameter of capital D equal to diameter of circular channel. For the maximum elastic of the fluid, the depth of water in the circular channel should be equal to 0.81 times of the diameter of the channel. Diameter of the channel. Maximum elasticity in the circular channel, the depth of the should be equal to 0.81 times of the capital D, diameter of the channel. For the maximum elasticity condition, we are construction based on, we are in the construction of the circular channel, we are based on this condition, we are construction, we are maintaining this condition for the maximum elasticity. Hydraulic mean for maximum elasticity is for that for maximum, this maximum elasticity. What is the value of hydraulic mean depth? For that we have find out the hydraulic mean depth condition for maintaining the maximum elasticity. We are need to find out the hydraulic mean depth condition. For that we have derived that condition. M equal to A by P. R, A equal to R square theta minus sine theta by 2 by 2 R theta equal to denominator and numerator RR cancel, getting R square and RR cancel, R by 2 theta is getting theta minus sine theta by 2. The theta equal to 180 degrees 45 minutes. Here approximate will take as 128.75 degrees. So 128.75 degrees into 1 by pi by 180 degrees is getting in the radians 2.247 radians. So M equal to R by 2 into theta value 2.247 radians minus 2.247 minus sine into 2 theta value 2 into 128 theta value equal to 128 degrees 45 minutes by 2. So R equal to 2 into 2.247 equal to 4.497. 4.497 into 2.247 minus sine into theta. Theta minus 180 minus 180 plus 87.5 by 2. This value equal to sine 257 degrees at 30 minutes. Here sine 180 degrees plus 87.5 degrees by 2. So R by 4.494 into 2.247 plus sine into 87.5 degrees by 2. here this value is getting a whole value is equal to 0.611 r, 0.611 r. Here r equal to d by 2, 0.611 into d by 2, 0.3055 d, 0.3055 d. That is taken as approximately 0.3 d. So here condition, we are maintaining the maximum elastic condition. We need to maintain this condition in the construction of the circular channel. That condition is hydraulic mean depth m equal to maintain 0.3 d. For maximum elasticity, the hydraulic mean depth is equal to 0.3 times of diameter of the channel. Diameter of the channel, capital D. Small m equal to 0.3 capital D. We need to remember these conditions. For small d equal to 0.81 d, m equal to 0.3 d. In the calculation of in the problems, we require to find out these conditions. These are the conditions for maximum elastic condition. For maximum elastic condition, we are maintain which conditions are maintain. The conditions are m equal to small d equal to 0.18 d, 0.18 d, and m equal to 0.3 d. These are the conditions we are maintaining under construction of the circular channel for getting the maximum elastic. Next, for getting the discharge in the construction of the circular channel, which condition we are maintaining based on that, which condition we are going to construction. Let's go into see condition for maximum discharge in circular channel. The formula is Q equal to AC root MI. Here AC into M is the value of A by P into I. So C equal to, here A is the root is getting the A power 1 by 2. So here A into A square, A power 1 by 2 equal to A cube. So C equal to A cube by P into I. This is Q equal to C root of A cube by P into I. So for this subject of maximum constant value, we need to differentiate the A cube by P value. We need to differentiate the hydraulic mean depth value A cube by P is equal to 0. Differentiate this equation with respect to theta. And the equation the same to 0. P into 3a square, differentiate with respect to theta. Dp by dt into p into dp by dt with respect to a cube equal to 3a square into p into 3a square is with respect to differentiate with respect to a theta to a cube is getting a 3a square. P into 3a square da by d theta minus a cube by dp by theta. Da by theta minus a cube by dp by d theta by p square equal to 0. So we write as 3p into a square, da by theta minus a cube by dp by theta equal to 0. P square into 0 equal to 0. So dividing a by a square on both sides, 3p into a square cancel, a square by a cube cancel, the remaining term is a square. So 3p into da by d theta minus a into dp by d theta. From the equation 16.6, p equal to 2r theta. So differentiate the vector perimeter 2 by with respect to theta is getting dp by d theta equal to 2 into r. Here differentiate with respect to theta is getting value 1, so 2r. From the equation a equal to r square theta minus sin to theta by 2, differentiate the area value with respect to the r square into differentiate with respect to theta into theta is getting the value 1 minus cos 2 theta. 1 minus cos 2 theta, differentiate the sin theta equal to cos is getting the sin 2 theta. Substitute the value is p, a, weighted perimeter value, a, area value, dp by differentiate with respect to weighted perimeter value, differentiate of area value is. Sub the values in equation 1. So equation 1 equal to 3 into p value equal to 2r theta into r. Area value equal to r square 1 minus cos 2 theta. r square 1 minus ka area will equal to da by theta equal to r square minus cos theta, a value equal to minus a value equal to a square r square into theta minus sin to theta by 2 into dp by dt I value equal to 2r, 2r equal to 0. So here 3 into 2, 6, 6r, r into square r, r into r square equal to r cube, 6r cube theta minus 1 minus cos 2 theta minus 2 into r square into r, 2r cube into 6 theta minus sin to theta, theta minus sin to theta by 2 equal 0. So dividing by r, 2r cube, we get, dividing with 2r cube, we get 6r cube by 2r cube equal to r cube cancel, 3 to the 2, 3 are 6, so remaining the term is 3 theta, 1 minus cos 2 theta, 2r cube by 2r cube equal to cancel, theta minus sin 2 theta by 2 equal to 0, here 3 theta minus cos 2, 3 theta minus, you are multiplying these terms with respect to, with 3 theta minus 3 cos 2 theta, 3 theta cos 2 theta minus theta minus into minus plus theta plus cos sin 2 theta by 2 equal to 0, equal to 0. So we are getting here 3 theta minus theta equal to 2 theta minus 3 theta cos 2 theta plus sin 2 theta by 2 equal to 0. So here we are getting 2 into 2, we are multiplying with respect to 2 in the denominator of the 2, 2 into 2, 4 theta minus 2 into 3, 6 theta, cos 2 theta plus sin 2 theta. We are multiplying with these terms with 2. So 2 into 2, 4 theta minus 2 into 3, 6 theta, cos 2 theta plus sin 2 theta equal to 0. By the solution of this, by the trial and error measures, approximately we are getting that 2 theta value equal to 308 degrees. So theta equal to 308 degrees by 2 equal to 154 degrees. Now find out the depth of the bow maximum discharge. Depth of the bow maximum discharge. Theta equal to OD minus OC equal to R minus R cos theta. R into 1 minus cos theta. R equal to 1 minus cos theta equal to 154 degrees. R into 1 minus cos 180 degrees minus 26 degrees. So we are getting the value r into 1 plus cos 26 degrees. This value is getting 1.898 r. Yes, substitute r value is d by 2. So 1.898 into d by 2. So 2 into 1.898 by 2 equal to, that value is getting 0.948 d, approximately 0.95 d. So small d equal to depth of the channel is equal to water equal, depth of the water flow is equal to 0.95 of the d. So for maximum velocity, depth of the flow is equal to 0.95 times of the diameter. For the maximum discharge condition, we are maintaining the condition small d equal to 0.95 d, and theta is the value getting maintained 154 degrees, and also here is the conditions based on this most economical surplus condition. We are going to explain the formula problems for the derivation of most economic surplus and first condition for maximum velocity. Based on that condition, I explain the problem to the related to that condition. The rate of flow of water through a circular channel of diameter is 0.65 meters, is 150 liters per second. Find the slope of the bed of the channel. Is maximum velocity, take series constant is 60 degrees. In the circular channel, it gives the discharge of the channel, diameter of the channel, and the series constant value is given. Find the slope of the bed of the channel. Find the I value of the channel. So let the slope of the bed of the channel is maximum velocity is equal to small I. For the maximum velocity of circular channel, depth of the flow is given. these formulas are fixed from which are getting from the derivation of the Magnus or most economical surplus condition. So you require to need to remember these values for calculating the problems. So small d equal to 0.81 d, 0.81 into d, 0.81 into d value equal to diameter of channel 0.6, at value 0.0486 meters. Small d equal to 0.0486 meters. 0.0486 meters. Theta value equal to is written 128 degrees 45 minutes. 128 degrees 45 minutes. This here converted into radians 128.75 into 128.75 into pi by 180. So getting the value, fixed value 2.247 radians. From the equation hydraulic mean depth of the for maximum velocity, hydraulic mean depth value is the fixed value which are derived from the derivation 0.3 into here capital D diameter of channel is already given 0.6. So we are getting the hydraulic mean depth value is 0.18 meters. Wetted perimeter of circle channel, this is the P equal to 2 pi r theta. This is the value, this 2 pi r theta value also getting from the derivation of the most economical circular channel. So r is the value of d by 2, such the r value is d by 2, denominator and numerator 2 are cancelled. So p equal to d into theta, d value is given as 6.6, theta value is 2.24 radians, 2.7 radians. So d value is getting 1.3482 meters. Wetted perimeter value is getting 1.2 3482 meters. Area hydraulic mean depth value is 0.18 meters. So here area value is, we are find out the area value from the m equal to a by p. Find out the area value from the m equal to a by p. So a equal to m into p, a equal to m into a m by p equal to value is getting here hydraulic mean depth value is 0.18. From this is required to find out the a value, a equal to 0.18 into p. So 0.18 into p value is getting here with perimeter value 1.348482. finally area value is getting 0.2426 meter square, 0.2426 meter square. Area value is getting here 0.2426 meter square. Wetted perimeter value is getting here 1.2482 meters. Hydraulic mean depth value is getting here 0.18 meters. So all values are getting here. So now the question is asked here, find the rate of flow, find the slope of the bed of the channel. So for the discharge, series constant value is Q equal to AC root of mi. From that we need to find out the I value. Discharge value is given 0.15, 50 liters into converted into meter cube is getting 0.15. If we divide the 150 with 1000, we are getting the 0.15 value. Substitute the value in this equation 0.15. A value is 0.2426 into 60 into series constant value is getting 60 into M value. M value, I don't mean it, value is getting 0.81 into I. So from these values, this is 6.125 I root I, 6.175 root I. So here I value is, we are required to find out I value. I equal root I equal to 0.15 by 6.175. The root value is converted into equal to our side is getting the square value 0.15 by 6.175 our square. Here we take the I in the fractions value. So only in the 1 by values, only in the one horizontal like that, one vertically in the fractions value, that 1 by 6 point is getting to write 1 by 6.17 by 0.15 whole square is getting the value 1 by 1694.7. So that slope is 1 by 1 in. We read this fraction 1 in 1694.7. This is the I value for the most economical circular condition. First condition related to the first condition of for maximum velocity condition, we are required to find out the bed slope of the channel. Next condition, in the most economic, next problem, the most economical circular channel for the second condition for the maximum discharge, we are find out the maximum discharge. by in the maximum discharge condition, in the related to the maximum discharge condition, by using that condition, we are required to find out the discharge. Determine the maximum discharge of water of the channel. Diameter of the channel, capital D is given 1.5 meters. The bed slope of the channel is given, I value is given 1 by 1000. Physics constant value is given 60. So from that, the D equal to 1 by 5. From that, we require to find out the small r radius 1 by 5, 1.5 by 2. R equal to D by 2. So 1.5 by 2 equal to 0.75 meters. So small r equal to 0.75 meters. For maximum discharge, theta equal to 154 degrees. Converted into radians, 154 into pi by 180, 2.687 in radians. 2.687 in radians. So, for the find out the wetted perimeter for the circular channel, this fixed value, adding from the derivation, 2 pi r theta, 2 into r equal to d by 2 into 2 pi theta r equal to 2.687. So, 2 into 1.5 by 2 into d value 1.5. So 2.687 equal to the wetted perimeter value equal to 4.0317 meters. Wetted perimeter value is getting here. Now the find out the wetted area of the channel. A equal to this equation is fixed equation. R square into theta minus sine to theta by 2. R is the 0.75 whole square. R is the 0.75 square into theta equal to 2.6878 minus sine into 2 into theta equal to 154 degrees. For the maximum discharge condition, theta equal to 154 degrees by 2. So 0.75 whole square, 2.6878 minus 2 into 154 equal to 308, sine 308 by 2, 0.75 whole square into 2.6878 minus, this value is writing like this, sine into 360 minus 52 degrees. This value is writing like this. This is 308 is getting from the 360 minus 52 degrees. So 0.75 square into 2.687 plus sine 52 degrees by 2. We are getting sine 52 degrees by 2 minus the 360 minus 308. Remaining value is 52. So sine 52 degrees by 2 is getting a value 1.7335. Now find out the hydraulic mean depth. Area value is getting here 1.7335. Now find out the hydraulic mean depth value. M equal to A by P. A is the value 1.7335 by P equal to value 4.0317. Is the getting value 0.4299. Hydraulic mean depth value is getting 0.4299. Now substitute these values. M value, A value, and the discharge value is given. All our unseries constant value is given. All our substitute values in this maximum discharge equation. T equal to AC root MI. T equal to 1.7335. A series constant C equal to 60 into M equal to 0.4299 into I value is getting slope of the bed 1 by 1000. Finally, getting the value 2.156 meter cube per second. For the find out the maximum discharge condition from the most economical circular channel. From the second condition of the determined condition of maximum discharge related to that, we derive the problem for related to that condition. This problem is related to first condition of the most economical circular channel condition for maximum velocity. Related to that condition, we are deriving the formula for the related to that condition. These are the problems under most economical circular channel condition of derivation. Next class I going meet with you with other topic. Thank you for giving this opportunity. Have a good day.